Howdy, howdy. This week in Chem 121, our lab is going to focus on, again, some additional laboratory equipment, as well as the whole idea of chemical and physical change. We're going to be doing 5 experiments, 2 of which are going to be done underneath the fume hood because they could potentially generate some noxious gases. I've set it up under 2 different fume hoods. You'll probably just use 1 fume hood and interchange the parts. Experiment 1 then uses a hot plate here, shown, a ring stand, and a special 3-pronged clamp that's holding a large test tube. Some ethanol is going to go into that test tube, and we're going to try and test, measure its boiling point. In order to do that, we're going to take a large beaker, fill it about 3/4 full water, put it on our hot plate, and then using our 3-pronged clamp, lower our test tube of ethanol into the water. We're then going to turn on our thermometer, gives us a digital readout in degrees C, and then we're going to turn on our hot plate to about 250 degrees. I'll probably preheat some water for you so we get kind of a jump start on this, and you'll just observe then until you begin to see the ethanol or liquid inside that test tube begin to boil. At that point, you'll just note the temperature, turn everything off, and we'll deal with the waste as written up in the lab. The second experiment, also done under a fume hood, involves a ring stand again, but now with a iron ring on it, and nestled into that iron ring would be a evaporating dish, and into that evaporating dish we're going to put a few crystals of copper sulfate, which is this blue stuff, and then we're going to light the burner. You'll probably want to check with me or Jen before you start to make sure your ring and your evaporating dish about the right height off of the burner. The gas controls over here on the side of the fume hood. You turn it all the way on, and then you use one of these magical strikers to ignite the gas. There's no reason to get nervous because the fume hood ensures that everything goes out. You can probably just barely make out the flame. You're instructed to heat it for 30 to 60 seconds as you observe. Then as you make your observations after 60 seconds, you'll turn off the gas. And of course, you'll have to allow the evaporating dish to cool before we dispose of the material. When you're done, you're going to take that evaporating dish and simply add some water back to it. Observe what happens. And when you're all done, then you can just use your wash bottle to rinse it right into a waste beaker, and we'll deal with the waste at the end of the lab. Experiments 3, 4, and 5 are very simple. They're going to involve these tiny test tubes, and we'll get out a bunch of them. And you're going to be in experiment 3, looking at the solubility of different substances. This happens to be sucrose or sugar, and you're just going to put a little bit, a very little bit, into the test tube. That test tube's wet, and so I'm going to try again. Maybe about that amount. And then you're going to add deionized water, again from your wash bottle, and agitate, shaking up and down side to side, and give it a few minutes to see whether or not the sugar dissolves, disappears, and note your results. You'll do the same test using water and iodine crystals, and then you'll do 2 more experiments using the little test tubes, mixing together chemicals and looking for evidence of chemical change, the evolution of heat and or light, dramatic unexpected color change, production of a gas, or the formation of a solid precipitate from aqueous solutions. Good luck.